Bien, mesdames et messieurs, chers amis, dear customers, dear colleagues, so welcome tonight for this launch.
Chers collègues, bienvenue pour ce lancement. Ce sera le troisième cette année avec Ariane 5 SIA en 2016. Nous lançons deux satellites ce soir pour DISH, EchoStar 18, qui couvrira les États-Unis continentaux, Alaska et Hawaï, et le satellite BRISAT pour la petite banque Rakyat d'Indonésie, qui servira 53 millions de clients de cette banque. Ce soir, il s'agira du 230e lancement avec le lanceur Ariane. C'est la première fois que Ariane lancera deux satellites de SSL et nous en sommes très fiers. Et cela nous mènera à un record de 9840 kg. Comme Bernard nous l'a expliqué il y a un instant, la météorologie est bonne ce soir, ce n'est pas un souci. Les opérations de chronologie finale se passent bien, mais nous avons légèrement recalé H0 Pro qui sera à 17h45 heure de Kourou. Donc 15 minutes plus tard que l'H0 qui était prévu tout à l'heure. La fenêtre de tir de lancement ira jusqu'à 18h40.
After 29 minutes and 20 seconds, and the separation of BRISAT after 42 minutes and 5 seconds.
So now we are just ready for this launch. Nous sommes prêts pour le lancement et je souhaite à tous un très beau spectacle et nous vous retrouverons dans quelques instants.
I'm Harry Thibodeau, and I welcome
Bonsoir
our global audience to Kourou French Guiana
for tonight's launch.
We're coming to you live from the Jupiter Launch Control Center, about 13 kilometers, 8 miles from the pad. There you see the star of tonight's broadcast, the Ariane 5 ECA, weighing in at 780 tons. Everything is going good, but of course you heard we will experience a slight modification in the actual launch time. We'll talk about that in a minute. The launcher stands 50 meters high, the boosters 30 meters high, roughly two-thirds of the weight of the entire vehicle. There you see we have indeed gone red on the count. We will continue that count to the 7-minute mark, and then we'll explain more about that. The vehicle you put in bay, computers control the flight from there. It's redundant, so the mission can go on if one fails. Upper passenger tonight, EchoStar 18 for DISH Network, weighs in
6.3 tons.
They and others are dedicated to the safe launch of EchoStar 18. Let's hear about EchoStar 18 now.
Travaillent à ce lancement.
Echo 18 will be the fourth spacecraft launched by Ariane Space or DISH Network since 1996, and we are very proud of the confidence DISH and EchoStar put in Ariane Space system reliability.
EchoStar 18
est le dernier né de la flotte de notre client Dish, fournisseur de télévision payante aux États-Unis. Depuis 20 ans déjà, les services de diffusion par satellite Dish fournissent une programmation et une technologie de pointe à leurs clients.
EchoStar 18 est un satellite de forte puissance et haute capacité qui offre une couverture de plus de 100 faisceaux ponctuels. Il s'agit du 13e satellite construit par SSL pour EchoStar et Dish. C'est le satellite construit par SSL qui dessert le plus grand nombre de zones de marché. EchoStar 18 est le 5e satellite de notre flotte à être lancé par Ariane. EchoStar 18 va accroître la couverture Dish existante en assurant le niveau de service le plus élevé à près de 14 millions de clients. Après la remise au client, EchoStar sera chargé des opérations et du contrôle du satellite face à nos centres d'opération à Cheyenne et Gilbert. Alors que nous préparons le lancement d'EchoStar 18, nous aimerions remercier les nombreuses équipes de SSL, Arianespace, EchoStar 18 et Dish qui ont contribué au succès de ce programme.
De retour à Jupiter, nous voyons à l'écran le lanceur. La météo est bonne, mais comme vous l'avez entendu, il y aura un léger retard. Les équipes terminent de travailler. Et nous allons en entendre plus sur BRISAT dans quelques instants. Et nous voudrions vous rappeler que c'est le premier satellite servant une banque.
BRISAT is the first satellite dedicated for a bank communication network. NBRI is making history by launching and operating its own satellite.
The satellite will operate from its orbital position at 150.5 degrees east
des services de communication hautement fiables à plus de 10 000 succursales de la banque BRI dans tout l'archipel indonésien.
Branches across the Indonesian archipelago.
BRISAT has 36
CBN transponders and 9 KUBN transponders couvrira l'Indonésie, l'Asie du Sud-Est et du Nord-Est.
I would like to express my appreciation
à SSL,
to Space System
fabricant, qui a réalisé un travail énorme en terminant le satellite juste à l'heure.
Such a tremendous job finishing the satellite.
Et je remercie
right
aussi Arianespace pour
and
son support pendant
like
la campagne de lancement.
Arianespace for their excellent support during this launch campaign.
Thank Merci you, à la Banque Rakyat d'Indonésie pour le lancement de son premier satellite au service d'une banque.
And as we return to Jupiter, we
de retour à Jupiter, nous voyons d'autres responsables de la mission de ce soir. Nous arrivons à une étape clé, les 7 minutes avant le lancement.
À tous de DDO, arrêt du décompte suite à un rouge ensemble de lancement. Que tous les moyens restent prêts pour la reprise de la chronologie à H0-7 minutes en cas de retour au vert.
Okay, there you heard the announcement from the DDO.
Vous avez entendu l'annonce du DDO. Nous avons arrêté la chronologie à 7 minutes. Et comme vous avez entendu Stéphane Israël le dire un peu plus tôt, nous avons simplement besoin d'un petit peu plus de temps. Les équipes ont besoin de travailler encore un peu. Les rouges sont un processus parfaitement normal des lancements ici à Kourou. Nous ne lançons pas avant que tout soit au vert. Et actuellement, les équipes ont simplement besoin d'un peu de temps supplémentaire pour terminer les opérations de préparation. On ne précipite rien. Nous prenons notre temps et nous serons de retour très rapidement avec le programme de diffusion de ce soir.
À tous de DDO, retour au vert de l'ensemble de lancement. Attention pour la reprise de chronologie.
And as we return to Jupiter, you can see that we have now gone green again on the screen and we are making
début de la séquence finale lanceur.
There's the announcement.
H0 est 21h38. Non. Le nouvel
announcement from the DDO that we will be resuming the count shortly.
We are green here at Kourou and waiting for the resumption of the count. And there it is, as we have now again begun the synchronized sequence.
21h, 38 minutes, 32 secondes. Je répète, 21h, 38 minutes, 32 secondes.
Ready, and the announcements continuing from the DDO. Computers again now taking more and more control to be sure that everything is okay. Time now to hear about the launch campaign that got us to this point this evening.
The different parts of the Ariane 5 launcher were shipped from Europe to the Periacabo port in Kourou. Launcher preparation operations began on the 21st of March in the integration building. The cryogenic main stage was removed from storage and placed in a vertical position. The two solid rocket boosters were also transferred. On the 1st of April, the upper cryogenic stage and the VEB were erected, and on the 3rd of May, the launcher was transferred to the final assembly building for integration of the payload.
The launch campaign started early with the arrival of the upper payload, EcoStar 18, at Félix Éboué Airport on the 20th of April and transferred to the H5C payload facility. Mechanical and electrical check started the day after with the mechanical fit check on the 21st of April. EcoStar 18 was transferred to the fueling facilities on the 2nd of May and propellant filling operations were performed without anomaly. BRISAT, the lower payload, landed at Félix Éboué Airport on the 9th of May and was transferred immediately to the S5C payload facilities. After mechanical and electrical check, the spacecraft was transferred to the fueling facilities on the 20th of April. The spacecraft was fueled without anomaly from the 21st to the 25th of May. Combined operations with launcher started with EcoStar 18 on the 10th of May with its flight mating on the payload adapter. EcoStar 18 was transferred to the BAF building on the 12th, hoisted on the Silda the 13th, and encapsulated under the fairing on the 14th of May.
Combined operations with the launcher with BRISAT started on the 26th of May, with its flight mating on the payload adapter. After transfer to the BAF on the 27th, it was hoisted onto the launcher on the 30th and encapsulated under Silda and fairing on the 31st of May. The Ariane Launch Readiness Review, held on Monday, authorizes the beginning of the final chronology with the launch vehicle transfer to the launch pad in order to be ready to launch today.
Already back in Jupiter, and look at that beautiful Ariane 5 ECA standing on the pad. And what's even more beautiful, just to its right, we are all green right now. At under 4 minutes to go to launch, everything is green, and again in Kourou, green means go. Look at how the weather has cleared up. You know, I'm a NASCAR fan. They'd call this Bill France weather clearing up for the launch this evening. And we never had a problem with weather tonight. It was yesterday that weather was the issue, but it looks like we're moving rapidly now toward the 3 minute mark in the countdown. Again, history tonight being made with this historic heavy payload, over 10,730 kilos. And again, made up of EcoStar with 6,300 kilos, EcoStar 18 for Dish Network, and BRISAT at 3,540. The remainder, the Silda and the support structures. Again, you know, hats off to the engineers here at the space base who have worked so hard to squeeze out additional performance from the Ariane 5 ECA, all of the engineers involved with it. We set a record back on VA 212 back in February 2013, and tonight we break that record by 337 kilos, closing in on the 2 minute mark before the launch this evening. And I'm getting excited because, like I say, I've I've been here quite a while, and I have been waiting for this moment as we get close to the actual countdown and liftoff. So at the two-minute mark, you see those two arms surrounding the Ariane 5 in Kourou. They're called the Bra. They're not actually holding the 780-ton rocket upright. That's gravity's job. The arms support the fuel lines, which are topping off the liquid propellants. We keep doing that till just before the launch, and then those arms will pull back. Well, they've been waiting a long time, too, and the VIPs are now heading out onto the balcony to watch the launch in the sundown here in Kourou. Bathed in sunlight, it is going to be quite a show coming up in a minute, 20 seconds from right now. As the Ariane 5 gets set to go, they're going to be watching it from the balconies. That's 13 kilometers from the Ariane 5 launch site.
Attention pour moins une minute.
There's the announcement we've been waiting for.
Stop. H0 moins une minute.
We are under 1 minute to go. We welcome everybody from around the world watching the live webcast on ArianeSpace.com. Greetings to our friends watching at Airbus Defense and Space in Europe, EchoStar and Dish Network, their headquarters in Inglewood, Colorado, PT Bank Raket in Jakarta, SSL in Palo Alto, California, Kness and ArianeSpace in Paris, all of our industry partners all across Europe. Even my wife, who's waited so long for me to get back to Denver. Only moments to go, and we will hear the famous countdown in French from Kourou. Enjoy the show.
À tous de DDO, attention pour le décompte final. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stop. Allumage Vulcain. Allumage des EAP, décollage. Les paramètres à bord sont nominaux.
For the history books and in the memory of the late great Muhammad Ali, the rumble in the Amazon jungle tonight is that mighty Ariane 5 ECA as she roars into the sky above Kourou. My 10th time that I've called a launch takes my breath away every time. We're 57 seconds into the flight. Ariane 5 breaking the sound barrier here in Kourou, and the massive Jupiter facility beginning to shake right now as the launcher roars out over Devil's Island, made famous by the movie Papillon. 1,300 tons of thrust breaking the Ariane 5, free from the bonds of Earth's gravity. 90% of that power coming now from the two boosters, each one 31 meters tall, 100 feet. They're burning 240 tons of solid propellant in 2 minutes, more than 2 tons a second. When the boosters have done their job, and that'll be in less than a minute from now, Ariane will be 70 kilometers in the sky, traveling more than a mile a second, faster than a speeding bullet. And you can see on the bottom of the screen the numbers, pertinent numbers for tonight's launch. And that data being collected from Galliata, a tracking station on a big hill behind us here at Jupiter. Engineers there evaluating all the data in real time. 2:07 into the flight. The VIPs still on the patio, and they're waiting for the burnout and jettison of the twin solid rocket boosters coming up in about 3 seconds from right now. And you will be hearing the announcement of the separation of the EAPs, the boosters, and the boosters will have done their job. They will fall away, and we won't need them any longer. And that will be occurring. There you see the animation. we've now lost about 600 tons worth of weight. The mass of the launcher, 180 tons, and all that's gone in about 2 minutes. The lighter we get, the faster we go. The next major event will be the jettisoning of the fairing. We'll see that in a moment. It will be gone in a few seconds. And it has protected the satellites on the ground and in their early minutes of the flight into the sky. There you see the animation of the coif or the fairing going away. We just lost 2 more tons. There's some great video from an earlier mission showing what it looks like as that fairing drops away. And the launcher is now 118 kilometers above Earth. We're technically in space. We still have a long, long way to go, however. I call your attention to the animation. You see all the numbers on the bottom of the screen. And we also will be watching the desired flight path in a moment on the upper right-hand side of the screen. See that curve and the green dot? We want to follow that curve perfectly. That means our performance is nominal. More key officials at Jupiter, Bruno Gerard, the vice president of Ariane Space, responsible for the establishment here in French Guiana. Joël Donadel, the head of ESA's offices here in Kourou, and Bernard Chamoul, the head of CSG for Kness. The main cryogenic stage, or EPC, now burning. It burns for about 9 minutes. And the EPC is really just a huge fuel tank. It holds 150 tons liquid oxygen, 25 tons of liquid hydrogen. That engine gulping 320 kilograms, 700 pounds of fuel a second. That's 500 times more than a jet engine. You know, I have absolutely no idea what the fuel mileage is on the Ariane 5, but it is built for speed and power, and in that arena, who cares about fuel economy? It is a workhorse. And there you see that we're moving out over the Atlantic Ocean. You know, I live in Denver, and one of the questions I frequently get from people is, why do I come here to French Guiana for a rocket launch? When do you come down here? Well, the space base is only 500 kilometers, 300 miles north of the equator. The Earth rotates faster at the equator than it does, say, at Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Thus, the Ariane 5 gets a huge boost from the Earth's rotation. This allows satellite operators, in many cases, to launch heavier payloads, add more fuel to their birds, and increase their operational life. And that generates more revenue. Just one more reason that Ariane Space is the undisputed champion of the commercial satellite launch industry. Oh, you know, and another question people ask, what about hurricanes? Well, I'm not a meteorologist, but the European Space Agency evaluated locations for the base. One thing they learned, hurricanes in the Western Hemisphere don't drop this low. Look at those pictures of the replay. Just 6 minutes, 28 seconds into flight as the Ariane 5 roared off the launch pad here in French Guiana. And, you know, seeing it roar off the pad reminds me of one other thing. You can never say never, but French Guiana doesn't have earthquakes. So the only time the Earth shakes down here is when that happens, which is one of the huge Ariane 5s or the Soyuz or the Vegas take to the sky from CSG. We are right on track at the 7 minute mark, and the rocket is currently 165 kilometers above the Earth. We're moving on out at great speed tonight. Final target, 9.3 kilometers per second. And, you know, a few more interesting facts. EchoStar 18 and BRISAT represent the 533rd and 534th satellites to be launched by Ariane Space. They also are the 119th and 120th satellites to be placed into geostationary transfer orbit by the workhorse of the fleet. The Ariane 5 has been picked up by our tracking station in Natal, Brazil. Everything functioning perfectly right now. Tonight we're using 5 tracking stations. Here in Kourou, it's Gilat, up on a large hill just south of us here at the launch base. Natal in Brazil. Ascension Island in the mid-Atlantic. The west coast of Africa, we've got Libreville. And on the east coast of Africa, we have Malindi. Ariane sends data to those ground stations, and that tells us how the flight is progressing in real time. And, you know, one of the secrets behind the whole thing is the teams evaluate absolutely every aspect of the mission. And they share that with all the customers. And every single time we fly, this complex machine gets better and better. And the Ariane 5 ECA has definitely proven itself. Our next major event, the cutoff of the main stage, or the EPC. And there's the
fin de la propulsion de l'étage principal cryotechnique.
Image and the announcement from the DDO. The main stage has now completed its job, and the upper stage has begun its mission. There you see images from a previous flight. You notice the little flash of light there? Well, the ignition, just before ignition, small rockets on either side of the upper stage fired, and that allowed the upper stage to move away. And then we safely ignite its engine and continue on the journey. Of course, immediately we dumped off those small rockets because,
again,
the lighter rockets fly faster. And we will now burn the upper stage, or the ESC, for about 16 minutes. Time now to hear about EchoStar 18.
Trajectoire est nominale.
Since 1980, Dish has been a leader in the satellite TV industry, offering the best value in entertainment. From its modest entrepreneurial beginnings to the evolution of its consumer pay TV service, Dish has earned a reputation for award-winning innovation, programming excellence, and superior customer care. The company that started with Charlie and Candy Ergen, Jim DeFranco, and a dream has grown to approximately 18,000 employees and nearly 14 million customers. Headquartered in Inglewood, Colorado, Dish uses multiple digital broadcast uplink centers located around North America to receive signals from hundreds of programmers around the world. Those signals are cleaned, compressed, and encrypted before being sent to Dish satellites orbiting 22,000 miles up in space. From there, the signals are sent to customers' homes, the equivalent of 4 trips around the Earth in the matter of just a few seconds. Dish's state-of-the-art service comes to life for customers with its full line of best-in-class equipment. Anchored by the revolutionary and most award-winning DVR ever, the Hopper, Dish takes the whole home entertainment experience to new heights.
Hopper was designed to leverage both the excellence and capability of our satellite fleet and merge that with the emerging mobile and internet technologies. So when we developed Hopper One, for example, we gave consumers truly unexpected features like Primetime Anytime, the capability to automatically record all their 4 primetime channels using a single tuner, so they would never miss out on any primetime show. And Hopper has continued to evolve. With Hopper 3, we now have 16 tuners, and customers can watch and record up to 16 shows at the same time. That is truly a conflict-free TV experience. And Hopper 3 also comes preloaded with popular apps like Netflix, Vivo, and Pandora. Hopper 3 is also the first major pay TV DVR that offers universal search that integrates search across live TV, DVR, on-demand, and even Netflix. Hopper 3 also has a special feature called Sports Bar Mode at Home, which allows consumers to take 4 channels and combine it into a single 4K video output. So you can watch up to 4 shows or 4 games at once, all in high definition, all on the same screen. Customers can also take their entire Hopper experience on the go with Dish Anywhere and Hopper Go that lets them watch live TV, DVR, and on-demand content, both with and without an internet connection. Many of these great features and capabilities of the Hopper 3 rely on the excellence and capacity of our satellite fleet. For example, we had to modify our uplink systems, our satellite systems, and the Hopper 3 software to be able to deliver primetime anytime. And when we talk about 4K video, our satellite fleet enables customers to watch the highest definition of video, no matter where they live, without having to worry about bandwidth constraints at home.
With the launch of Echo 18, Dish looks forward to continuing its leadership in providing the absolute best value, unmatched technology, and a superior customer experience to millions of consumers.
We're back at Jupiter. All continues to go well. And we see that we're almost over to Africa right now. Amazing how fast the Ariane 5 moves out. The fourth satellite that EchoStar has entrusted to Ariane Space. And as you heard, the 6.3-ton satellite will provide enhanced services to nearly 14 million DBS customers of Dish Network LLC. And you see many of the officials there from EchoStar and Dish Network. And again, some great award-winning technology that they bring to the marketplace. And of special note, this satellite also carries a spot beam covering Cuba, which will usher in new TV options for that island nation. 14 minutes and 45 seconds into the mission. All is well, and time now to take a look at BRISAT, making history tonight itself.
This is our homeland, made of thousands of islands. A land with dynamics of its own, from city areas to remote areas, facing challenges together. And here we are, born and raised between diversity of dynamics, areas, and human characters, working hard with the children of the nation, committed to reach the unreachable areas, to serve people with outlets spreading throughout the archipelago, experiencing the pulse of transaction with extensive BRI e-channels. Grateful for being your personal financing assistant with the largest ATM network in the country. Breaking transaction limitations by providing EDCs to the most remote places. Exploring the country with IBAS BRI. Reaching inaccessible areas with a fleet of mobile microbanking vehicles. It's an honor for us to serve you every day, no matter where you are. Our achievements are reflections of our commitment. We never stop to serve better. We're confident to be a problem solver to Indonesia's banking access to bring financial inclusion to all people. We proudly present BRISAT, the first and only satellite owned by a bank. In collaboration with Space System Laurel, a satellite manufacturer from US, and Ariane Space as provider of rocket launchers. The rocket is planned to be launched in June 2016 from Kourou in French Guiana, and this Ariane 5 rocket will launch BRISAT into space. This is the future of Bank BRI. Better banking services for all, to reach the unreachable, to offer advanced services in urban and remote areas all over Indonesia, to respond to challenges, to fulfill needs, to state our mission. We exist to connect Indonesia. Bank BRI, the national bank that serves all equally.
Returning to Jupiter, and as we close in on the 18-minute mark of the flight, all continues to go perfectly. The Ariane 5 and its valuable payloads have been acquired by our tracking station in Libreville, located on the west coast of Africa. Amazing, 20 minutes to go from Kourou to Africa. Another first tonight, we're launching two satellites made by one manufacturer, Ariane Space's longtime customer SSL of Palo Alto, California. The first SSL bird to fly on Ariane was Intelsat 5F7. That was back in 1983. In all 51 satellites from SSL or its predecessors have been orbited by Ariane Space. Space Systems Loral is a leading provider of commercial satellites with broad experience to support satellite operators all across the broad range of innovative space-related missions. The company designs and manufactures spacecraft for services such as direct-to-home television, video content distribution, broadband internet, mobile communications, and Earth observation. And you know, we have 10 more SSL satellites that are on the order book right now for launching. Azure Space 2IS 38, BSAT 4A, Intelsat 36, JSAT 15, also SkyMuster 2 for Australia, Star 1 D1, and four of the SkySat satellites. So a lot more left to come for SSL. Well, we're closing in on 20 minutes in. Time to hear more from SSL.
The launch of EchoStar 18 and BRISAT represents the first dual launch for two SSL-built satellites on an Ariane 5 launch vehicle. The spacecraft had a combined launch weight of 9,840 kilograms. The larger satellite, EchoStar 18, will be launched from the upper position. BRISAT will launch from the lower position. Both geostationary satellites are based on SSL's 1300 platform, which provides high power and extensive flexibility while supporting a wide range of sophisticated technology options for SSL's customers. SSL has formed strong and lasting partnerships worldwide, delivering spacecraft that provide a broad range of services and capabilities that help its customers expand their businesses. In today's environment of evolving demand for telecommunications infrastructure, satellites built by SSL help deliver entertainment, information, and critical data around the world. SSL designed and built BRISAT for BRI, the leading bank in Indonesia, and the first bank to own and operate a satellite. BRISAT will enable BRI to expand secure banking communications for 10,600 branches, 237,000 electronic channel outlets, and 53 million customers across the Indonesian archipelago, including locations where banking services were previously unavailable. With SSL's dedication and commitment to the BRISAT program, the satellite was successfully delivered on time to meet BRI's very aggressive 24-month business schedule. In addition, SSL provided a complete ground system, including two satellite control facilities.
Working together with SSL team in this BRISAT project is a good experience. We share mutual understanding and common spirit to make the project succeed.
With BRISAT, we're proud to be the first bank in the world that's owned and operates satellite.
DISH and satellite operator EchoStar have a long history in the direct broadcast satellite industry, providing direct-to-home television services to DISH customers for more than 20 years. Throughout that time, SSL has built 13 geostationary satellites, including EchoStar 18, for DISH and EchoStar. EchoStar 18 is a massive satellite with more than 100 spot beams. With the addition of EchoStar 18, DISH will have exceptional sparing capability for its fleet and will ensure outstanding reliability for its customers. EchoStar 18 will be operated by EchoStar, with spacecraft telemetry, tracking, and control services provided by multiple spacecraft operation centers. SSL thanks and congratulates BRI, EchoStar, DISH, Arianespace, and the SSL team on the launch of two highly capable satellites that bring services that will improve lives and make the world a better place.
And as we return to Jupiter, we're at the 24 and a half minute mark, basically, into the flight. All continues to go really well. We're now being tracked by the Malindi station on the east coast of Africa under 25 minutes, and we are nearly all the way across Africa. As I said earlier, Ariane 5 is built for speed and power, and right now there's no way Superman could even catch the Ariane 5 ECA. It's over 9 kilometers per second now, and 630 kilometers into the sky, 9.34 kilometers per second, 9.35 kilometers per second, and really moving out. The powered portion of the flight is now ending, and the need for that powered flight has basically ended. You heard the announcement by the DDO. The events will begin to happen pretty rapidly now. We've entered what we call the ballistic stage. Engineers here call it the SCAR phase. But for us normal people, let's refer to it as the space ballet. The powerful computers that we talked about a little earlier on board the Ariane 5 are making the calculations to align the vehicle perfectly now for the next steps. Let's assess what's happening here. We're high enough. We're going fast enough. The need for raw power is over. Now it's all about pinpoint precision. This is where the guys with the pocket protectors come into play. The real science in rocket science. The upper stage has a brain. A powerful computer in the vehicle assembly bay called the VEB. Even more than being a computer, it's a whole flight management system. And it can make decisions. It's extremely smart. It takes into account information flowing in from all of the systems of the rocket, from the fuel tank, the engine, you name it. If there are different options, it will always choose the one that maximizes the success of the mission. I'd love to have it in Vegas with me, right, when I'm gambling. The launcher needs to know right now where it is, where it has to go, and how it's going to get there. That's what we call GNC, Guidance, Navigation, and Control. It's one of the primary subsystems that are involved with the launcher. And you see that We are indeed very high right now, 1,018, 1,020 kilometers into the sky. And we're definitely going fast enough for the mission this evening at 27:50, almost 28 minutes into the flight. And the very first step of this orbital ballet that we talk about is to orient the launcher for the release of EchoStar 18 for Dish Network LLC. And every once in a while, you'll see a little flashes of light in the animation here. Small rockets on the side of the launcher are being fired to adjust the orientation. Very fine orientation. And again, this is rocket science that we're involved with. And needless to say, many, many years of hard work by everybody at EchoStar coming down to the next few seconds, and a set of springs will eject EchoStar 18 at exactly the right moment. And that's going to be coming up in about 20, 30 seconds from right now. And I know those guys work hard. I work for a company called Viasat, and I'm right across the freeway from the Dish Network offices and a lot of those folks. So they do a great job, and they've been in the industry for many, many years, pioneers.
Separation du satellite EchoStar 18.
And there it is at right on time, about 29:15. You can see some of the smiles that when I look down here from the balcony, the VIP area, I can see the smiles of people at Kourou. But the applause traditionally is withheld until both satellites have been separated. EchoStar 18 will be used by Dish Network, as we said, Dish Network LLC, to provide enhanced services to nearly 14 million Dish Network customers. On a personal note, as I said, I've been in the satellite industry in the United States for about 30 years now. I've known Charlie Ergen and the key leaders of both EchoStar and Dish Network since their formation. And yet again, another star twinkles in the evening sky for those folks tonight with EchoStar 18. So now the next act of the space ballet begins. We need to turn the composite away from the direction that we just sent EchoStar 18. Then we are going to prepare to jettison the Silda. And the Silda is that black structure that's sort of tough to see against the darkness of the Earth there, because we are in the dark part of the planet right now. But it's a small fairing, and it's the secret sauce that makes dual launch satellite launches possible here in Kourou. It has protected BRISAT and provided the base upon which we mounted EchoStar 18. And we want to be sure that we send it away from either of those two satellites. And Ariane Space uses seven different versions of the Silda. They range in size from 4.9 to 6.4 meters. They weigh between 400 and 530 kilograms. So these things are pretty big pieces of metal, okay? And when the Silda does separate at about 34:30 into the flight, BRISAT will be exposed to space for the first time. And by the way, I mentioned the sizes of the Sildas. We're using the big one tonight on this mission. As you heard earlier, BRISAT was built by SSL for PT Bank Rakyat, one of the largest state-owned banks in Indonesia. And if you remember your geography, Indonesia is a massive country. I mentioned earlier that about 17,000 islands. Well, this bank has 10,600 optional or operational branches across those islands, nearly 237,000 electrical channel outlets, or I think we call them ATMs in the United States, probably. In all, 53 million Indonesian citizens use that bank. And obviously, the only technology that could ever, ever make it possible to pull them all together is satellite. You know, it's amazing to consider how big modern satellites are. You might recall the first man-made satellite placed in orbit was Sputnik. That was on October 4th of 1957, and it was 58 centimeters, 24 inches in diameter, a ball. It weighed 83 kilograms, 184 pounds. All it could do really is send out a beep tone. But it represented an amazing leap in technology, and that little beep was the spark that ignited the space race and focused the attention on to satellite communications. Many of the people you're seeing right now probably got their start or their dream in the satellite industry because of those early days of the space race. Well, compared to Sputnik tonight, EchoStar 18 was a giant. It stood 8.3 meters tall. That's over 25 feet when deployed. The solar panels, I don't have the exact measurement, but over 30 meters. And an incredible 13 kilowatts of power for that satellite. 61 high-powered transponders. BRISAT, we call it the smaller of two satellites. But again, it stood... or stands 5.6 meters high. You know, we talked about Sputnik. Sputnik ran out of power, went silent 21 days after it was launched. It re-entered the atmosphere and burnt up on January 4th, 1958. So, anyway, there you see it. The Silda sliding away now, and it has been separated, and for the first time, BRISAT is exposed to space, and very soon we'll see sunshine for the first time. And we're now over, 2,500 kilometers above Earth, and we're just under 8 kilometers per second, 8 times the speed of a bullet, basically. And some 13 plus thousand kilometers in space. So we are now out basically over the Indian Ocean between Africa and Australia. Yet another act of the space race now begins, or the space ballet rather. The onboard computers are calculating the exact changes necessary for dropping off BRISAT. And obviously, we don't want to collide with either EchoStar 18 for Dish Network or the Silda that we just dropped off. And again, you don't want to bump into something in space. That makes for a bad day. More rocket science and orbital physics coming into play right now, high over the Indian Ocean. The space ballet continues as we prepare for that separation of BRISAT. Again, that's going to happen about 42 minutes into the flight, some 4,300 kilometers above the Indian Ocean at a speed about 7 kilometers per second. Not only do we have to orient the satellite composite in a safe and correct direction, we have to take one more step. Each one of the customers have specific requirements for the insertion of their satellites into geostationary transfer orbit, GTO. Both BRISAT and EchoStar 18 ask Arianespace to spin up their satellites, so to speak, before separation. That process will begin shortly. For BRISAT, it will have what is known in the business as a transversal spin rate of 1.5 degrees per second. There comes the pocket protector and the rocket science again here, right? But that will be the spin rate when the computers in the vehicle equipment bay say that it's okay, and they released the satellite to begin its life in space. You know, and the information that you see down at the bottom of the screen here and all of this data, it's flowing back here to Jupiter to something called the CVI. And a number of people are following and analyzing the key flight data. They report to Ariane 5's flight status, so they give the flight status to the team that's back here at Jupiter, all those guys that are down in the so-called fishbowl in front of us here. The CVI is headed by a person by the name of Natalie Philippe, and the Jupiter Mission Control Center is in constant contact with all the facilities that are necessary for launching and following the Ariane 5 rocket. The displays at the Galliette facility allow us to check the main parameters concerning propulsion, piloting, and trajectory. And they also provide the customers a first round of information, which is called an orbital diagnosis when separation actually occurs. The complete post analysis performed about a week after after the launch. So we are closing in now, and we're hit the 39-minute mark since the Ariane 5 ECA roared off the pad in the sunset of the Amazon jungle. And the rocket science of the orbital ballet continues. The upper stage and BRESAT are nearly in the correct attitude and configuration necessary for us to send BRESAT on its way. We are, about 3 minutes away from the separation of BRESAT. Probably three of the longest minutes the folks at BRESAT have ever had. And every time I look at the numbers for Ariane Space, it absolutely amazes me. We have just seen EchoStar 18 go on its way. It represented the 533rd satellite to be launched by Ariane Space. In a couple of minutes, that number is going to grow to 534 when we successfully separate BRESAT. And I often call the Ariane 5, the Ariane 5 ECA, the heavyweight champion of the commercial launch industry. Well, she's earned that recognition and that title. Tonight, she's placing the 119th and 120th satellites into geostationary transfer orbit since she arrived here at CSG in 2002. You know what is really amazing when you see how this whole thing operates down here? As I said, my 10th time coming to Kourou. Ariane Space and its partners make it look so routine. If you think about the many, many parts of this magnificent machine, a lot of them were built in Europe. They're delivered thousands of miles by two specialized boats. The satellites are flown in by massive cargo jets into Cayenne, French Guiana. They're then placed on very special trucks, and they are delivered to the space base about 60 kilometers away. And then a full month's worth of work has to go in to test and integrate and prepare for a launch. And it's absolutely amazing how time and time and time again, because of attention to detail and professionalism, the folks at Ariane Space and all of their partners make it look so very, very easy. And it's real rocket science. Anyway, high above the Indian Ocean, BRESAT, the first dedicated satellite ever to be launched by a bank, is about to be delivered. Let's hear the announcement coming up in a moment.
Separation du satellite BRESAT.
Hey, right on time. And now the celebration can begin. And you see it there. The call from the DDO. The celebration is on. And Ariane 5 has delivered again. One can only imagine the thrill being experienced by the officials from both EchoStar and Dish Network, along with BRISAT. Years of work coming down to the last hour, and they placed a lot of confidence in Ariane space, and the Ariane 5 ECA paid off tonight in a major way, placing them both into GTO. And that's probably one of my favorite times of the whole broadcast when I do these, is to watch these individuals shaking hands and enjoying it. Time now to hear about the historic heaviest payload. And as we return live to Jupiter, you see Stefan Israel moving to the podium.
Mesdames et messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests. So Ariane Space is delighted to announce that EchoStar 18 and BRISAT have been separated as planned on the targeted standard geostationary transfer orbit. If you allow me, I will say a few words in French, because when I was thinking during the preparation of the launch of what I could say. And you know, we are in the Euro Cup, and we often say in France que le football est un sport qui se joue à 11.
Football is a team which is played by 11 players, and it's always the same team that wins in the end. Preparing the launch, it was my feeling that launching is a wonderful sport which is played from the CSG, and in the end, Ariane wins.
The job and delivered on our promise of mission to success. So EchoStar 18 is about to augment Dish's existing fleet for direct broadcast satellites with a high-power multi-spot beam covering continental United States, Alaska, and Hawaii. It is the fifth satellite launched by Arianespace for Dish, continuing our close cooperation that started 20 years ago with the launch of EchoStar 2 in 1996. So we want to thank Dish, with CEO Charlie Ergen and representatives have been following our launch from Denver. We want to thank CTO Derek DeBastos, he was with us in the fishbowl. And Arianespace will be very happy to have new opportunities for Dish. BRISAT, the second passenger of this flight, is the first satellite owned by Bank BRI and the first fully owned by a financial institution. With this first satellite, BRI will deliver innovative services for access to easy, safe and fast banking products for more than 10,600 operational branches and 53 million customers across the Indonesian archipelago. So I want to testify my deepest gratitude to Bank BRI and to its CEO, Asnawi Siam, who is with us today. And I really want you to thank you for entrusting IronSpace. You have been patient, but you have made the right choice. We were sure of that. It's always better and easier to tell it after, but we had no doubt on that. And we will be happy to deliver more for Bank BRI. I want also to say that we have delivered a lot for Indonesia yet since Palapa C2, it was 20 years ago. It is tonight the fifth satellite we launch for Indonesia. We will have a new launch for Indonesia, it's Telkom 3S, and we hope to have many more. I would like also to acknowledge our long-standing partner, SSL, represented today by David Pigeon. SSL built both satellites for this mission. It is a premiere for us to have you both on lower and upper position. This launch brings the total to 55 SSL satellites launched by IronSpace. We have 10 more to deliver together, so it shows how important is our partnership and how deep is our partnership. Let me emphasize also the fact that today we have made a record with Ariane 5. We have delivered more than 10.7 tons, metric tons, to a geostationary transfer orbit. It corresponds to an overall performance gain of 1.4 metric tons since the beginning of the Ariane 5 VCA program. And with the support of ESA, with the support of CNES, and in partnership with our prime Airbus Safran launchers, further activities are already underway to increase this performance step by step by about 300 kilos in 2018. Our goal is definitely to keep on improving the Ariane 5's overall competitiveness and performance before the introduction of Ariane 6 to always exceed the expectations of our customers. So with our fifth successful launch of the year, the third with Ariane 5, IronSpace is on track for an excellent launch tempo in 2016. I want now to thank all the partners of this new success, because success in space is collective. ESA and all the member states of the Ariane program, whose support is absolutely crucial. CNES, for sure, both qualification authority for Ariane 5, and our day-to-day partner here in CSG. We have worked a lot to make the launch tonight, and I want to thank Bernard Chemoul, head of CNES CSG, for his support. I think we really work as a team here, and it's wonderful for further successes. Airbus Safran Launchers, Ariane Prime and first shareholder of IronSpace, is for sure a key partner for this success. And I wish also to mention all our contractors in French Guiana and all employees of the launch facility. Last but not least, I want to pay my tribute to the IronSpace team. They have done a tremendous job one more time. Our co-head was Frédéric Fachin. He has shown a degree of master, which is very impressive. So thanks again to all our IronSpace colleagues for this 230th launch of an Ariane vehicle from the CSG. So I now like to welcome our customers and partners. And so we will have now Derek De Bastos from EcoStar coming with us. Thank you very much.
Well, that was sure worth the wait. I suppose if it were possible to drink a several hundred million dollar bottle of Bordeaux, tonight's success is pretty much exactly what it would taste like. Congratulations to everyone tonight. 9.84 tons in orbit, 6.3 of which was EchoStar 18. One ton of that, or almost one ton of that, was the antenna subsystem alone, which to me is remarkable considering that when I first had my mission, my very first mission here in Kourou, it was 1989, and at the time the spacecraft weighed 700 kilograms. Its power budget would barely light up two transponders today on EchoStar 18. A lot has changed in those 27 years. Two things have remained the same. One is it never gets old. And two is words are inadequate to describe the thrill of launch day, particularly when it's your own launch. I'm reminded of a friend of mine who works at a rival company who has stood at this very podium on a couple occasions, and he's used his best baby French to describe in his best capacity the launch. C'est magnifique, superbe, parfait, and so on. Those words are okay, but maybe not parfait. So I consulted my experts, who are my children, aged 12, 14, and 16. They're all studying French. Through the magic of the internet, they're able to tell me what they thought. And I'm giving the following. Epic, prime, legit, totally beast. These are the words teens and tweens today use when they think of our industry, which I think is magnificent. If describing the launch day is hard, thanking all the people who are responsible for getting here is next to impossible. There's only a few that I can mention. First, to Dish, our customer, thank you very much for continuing to entrust us to build, launch, and fly your satellites. To my colleagues at EchoStar, thank you for doing the work every day that enables this trust. To Arianespace, this is our fifth mission with Arianespace. Thank you for those successes. Thank you for setting the standard for the rest of the world to follow with regards to reliability. To SSL, this is our 13th satellite. We've had a long and rewarding relationship. We've got several more satellites in the factory. Thank you for all of those spacecraft. I look forward to the future. Today we celebrate a launch. I think we have acquisition confirmed. Once we get the orbit raising complete, IoT finished, handover, and 15 years of uninterrupted service, we can celebrate a successful satellite. To Bank BRI, congratulations on your very first satellite. Thank you for being the co-passenger and sharing our ride. And the people who are not here tonight, there is one very important group. And on behalf of anybody who's left a home to come here to support the campaign, thanks to our families whose love and support. It makes it all worthwhile while we trot about the globe, building our satellites and launching our rockets, especially to my family, my wife Lisa, my son Ricky, and the reason for my hair, my daughters Katie and Gia. Thank you, you guys are great. You make this day worthwhile. So to all of you here, all of you who are not here, anyone who I forgot, anyone who's worked to get to today, anyone who's working to get to tomorrow, thank you. You guys are prime. You guys are epic. You guys are legit. You guys are totally, totally beast. Thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, allow me to express my happiness, pride, and relief that today we can all witness the launch of PRISAT. It was truly a remarkable moment. And for this, on behalf of BRI, I would like to say thank you and to congratulate Arianespace and on the successful launch of PRISAT. And congratulations to PRISAT's co-passenger, EchoStar. To Stephen Israel and all Arianespace team, we are especially grateful for you, your quick and response in handling the delay, and for working hand on hand with us. And thank you for your professionalism. For SSL, David, Pigeon, and team, thank you for the collaboration. We fully appreciate SSL's commitment to finish and the satellite on time. Ladies and gentlemen, with the launch of BRISAT, we are proud to be the first and the only bank in the world that own and operate a satellite. It's not only a proud moment for BRI, but also for our country, Indonesia. This satellite is symbolized our spirit and vision to serve our customer better and to bring more benefit to our country. We hope that BRISAT will mark a new era in banking and stepstone for the financial industry, not only in Indonesia, but also in the world. Again, congratulations to all of us. Thank you. God bless.
Well, good day. Let me start with something a bit personal. I love sunsets. And today's sunset was the best I have ever seen. With that launch coming up there, just beautiful. But let me say congratulations to the 2,000 employees of Space Systems Loral back in California right now, who have put their hard work and effort into making those two satellites, designing them, building them, getting them ready to launch. Our teams down here have been here for the last 45 days, as well as yours. And I just want to say congratulations. Excellent work. Excellent work. And speaking of excellent work, to Stefan and your team, all of Ariane Espace, and everyone here, both in French Guiana and in Europe, excellent work. Just tremendous. 72 straight successes. We're proud to be a good partner with you. We enjoy the collaboration and the openness that we have together. And from John Celli and our executive team, thank you very much and congratulations. And to our customers, it's not typical that we have two customers here today, but we do. To Pakas Maui, thank you for your trust in us, for the ability for us to partner with you, your excitement and the enthusiasm and your ingenuity in your ability to do something that no one else has done. It's an honor for us to be a part of your success, so thank you. And to Derek, where are you? There you are. Yes, we've worked together quite a lot. To you and to Dish and to all of your executive team, we have built a lot of satellites for you. This is the 13th. We have three more in the factory to go. We are very honored to continue to earn your trust. Thank you very much. Much. So one more thing, and then we'll close, and that is that I have indications that both satellites have been received and telemetry is streaming down to our mission control center in Palo Alto, California. That means those satellites are in the right place, and they're streaming and operating just like they're intended to do. So congratulations to everyone. We have some work to do to get those solar rays out tonight, and then everyone can celebrate. But we'll celebrate with you. Thank you.
So ladies and gentlemen, it's now time to close this launch and this party. So we will come back here in CSG on August the 24th, and it will be for Intelsat. And Intelsat has chosen to take the whole rocket after having done with one satellite in January. Now Intelsat makes the same choice with two satellites for Intelsat 33E and Intelsat 36. And we are very happy to prepare this next launch of Ariane. Thank you very much to all of you. Thank you very much for all the people we will see this launch from different locations, and I would say especially in Jakarta, because it was really a premiere for you as a customer, and I know what a premiere means. Other customers and partners have more experience, but a premiere is something you will never forget. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.
Well, my friends, another incredible Ariane 5 mission has come to an end. And tonight, spectacular as a sunset launch here in the Amazon jungle. It's with great pride that we can say that over 60% of all of the commercial satellites in orbit worldwide have been launched from this spectacular facility. And we're going to see some replays of that in just a moment. You see everybody having a great celebration and enjoying the last few moments here in Kourou. It's been my honor to serve as your host again tonight. The first time I came to Kourou was back in 2007, and I look forward to many more opportunities to share the excitement of a launch from French Guiana. Again, we say congratulations to everybody involved in VA-230, especially the folks from EchoStar and Dish Network and BRISAT. For the world's number one launch services provider, Ariane Space, I'm Harry Thibodeau, bidding you good night from Kourou, French Guiana.